Konnichiwa, welcome to Learn Japanese with Masa-sensei. Today in this video, we will cover JLPT N3 grammar. I will read out 15 questions. If you want to take time, please pause the video and write down your own answer. After that, I will explain the grammar point. Now let's see how many you can get them correct. Now let's go. 1番 田中さん 何々 山田さんが プレゼンをします。田中さん、何々、山田さんがプレゼンをします。 Now, what is the answer? The answer is に代わり. So, this sentence means on behalf of 田中さん, 山田さん will do the presentation. If you look at B, it says を代わって. We don't have such grammar. If it's に代わって, this is correct. So, に代わり and に代わって are the same meanings. It means on behalf of someone. 2番 弟は背が高い 何々 お兄さんは背が低いです。 弟は背が高い 何々 お兄さんは背が 低いです. A is のに対して, B is に対して. Now what is the answer? The answer is のに対して. So に対して means in contrast to. So when you compare two things, we will use に対して. So it is verb plain form plus のに対して. I adjective plus のに対して, な adjective plus なのに対して, verb plus なのに対して. So this sentence means, the younger brother is tall. In the contrast, the elder brother is short. So the answer is のに対して. 3番 コーチ、私を試合に 何々 コーチ、私を試合に、何々。 A. 出てください。 B. 出させてください。 Now what is the answer? The answer is B. 出させてください。 So, コーチ is coach. 試合 is match. 試合に出ます is to join the match. When someone makes you join the match, it will be 試合に出させます. So this is a causative form. Causative form plus ください. This means, please let me do something. So, 試合に出させてください. This means, please let me join the match. So this causative form plus ください is used when you want to ask for a permission. The answer is B. 出させてください. 4番 注文に何々お問い合わせは電話でお願いします。注文に何々お問い合わせは電話でお願いします。 A. 関して B. 関する. So what is the answer? The answer is 関する. So 関して and 関する. Both means about, concerning, in regards to, regarding. However, if it's between two nouns, it will be 関する. Noun plus に関する plus noun. So 注文 is order. 問い合わせ is queries. So, 注文に関する問い合わせ. So, queries in regards to the order. 電話でお願いします is please make a phone call. So, the answer is に関する. に関して is used when there is no noun after. So, for example, 私は 語学に関して興味があります。私は 語学に関して興味があります。I have an interest about languages. 5番、お正月の祝い方は国に何々違います。お正月の祝い方は国に何々違います。A is 寄って、B is 取って。Now what is the answer? The answer is 寄って、寄って。So 寄って has many meanings. One meaning is depends on. So in this case, お正月の祝い方。お正月 is January 1st in Japan. 1月1日。祝います is to celebrate. So the way to celebrate is stem word plus 型。祝い方。The way to celebrate 国によって違います。It is different depending on the countries. So here the answer is よって。とって means from the standpoint of someone or something. So for example,
私にとって家族が一番大切です。私にとって家族が一番大切です。
From my standpoint, family is the most important. So this is not the answer in this case.
6番、説明書を何々、こんな間違いはしなかったのに、説明書を何々、こんな間違いはしなかったのに。A、読むだけすれば。B、読みさえすれば。
Now what is the answer? The answer is B、
読みさえすれば。
説明書 means manual. Verb, stem word plus さえすれば。This means if only.So,
読みさえすれば
if only I had read.
こんな間違い
So, こんな is such.
間違い
is mistake.
しなかったのに
So, this のに which comes at the end of the sentence is used when you want to blame someone.
説明書を読みさえすればこんな間違いはしなかったのに。
If only I had read the manual, I wouldn't have done such mistake. So the answer is B.
読みさえすれば。
If you look at A, it says だけすれば。However, this one doesn't make sense. There is no such grammar.
7番。日本での経験を何々?たくさんのことを学びました。日本での経験を何々、たくさんのことを学びました。A is 通って、B is 通して。
Now what is the answer? The answer is
通して。
B is the answer.
日本での経験。
The experience in Japan
通して is through.
So, 日本での経験を通して means through my experience in Japan,
たくさんのことを学びました。
I learned many kind of things. The answer is
通して。
通って。This is simply the te form of 通ります。通ります means to pass by. So it doesn't fit in this sentence. The answer is B.
通して。8番、日本語を教える何々、中国語を教えてください。日本語を教える何々、中国語を教えてください。
A is 代わりに、B is おかげで。Now what is the answer? The answer is
代わりに。
代わりに、we have learned that it meansOn behalf of. However, it also means in exchange to.
So in this case, 日本語を教える。So to teach Japanese. 代わりに in exchange to teach Japanese, 中国語を教えてください。Please teach me Chinese. So here the answer is A. 代わりに。おかげで means thanks to, because of, due to. This is only used for positive thing. So for example,
日本に留学したおかげで日本語が話せます。日本に留学したおかげで日本語が話せます。
Because I studied in Japan, I can speak Japanese. So in this case, the answer is A. 代わりに。
9番。今から私が言う何々書いてください。今から私が言う何々書いてください。A は通りに、B は通りに。
Now what is the answer? The answer is B.
通りに。
So, 通りに and 通りに both means as, in the way as. So it will become verb plus 通りに and noun plus 通りに。So, 言う通りに means as I say.
今から私が言う通りに書いてください。
Please write as I say from now. If it's after a noun, it will become
通りに。プロジェクトは計画通りに進みました。プロジェクトは計画通りに進みました。
The project went according to the plan. So, 計画 is plan, it's a noun, so we will use 通り。In this case, 言う is a verb, therefore we will use 通りに。
10番。一週間に何々激しい雨が続きました。一週間に何々激しい雨が続きました。A は渡って、B は寄って。
Now what is the answer? The answer is
渡って。に渡って means
throughout a period of time, throughout the area. So 一週間に渡って means throughout 1 week or during 1 week.
激しい雨 is a heavy rain. 続きました is continued.
So in this case, the answer is
渡って。によって。
This has several meanings.The first one is because of, due to.
コロナウイルスによってたくさんの人が亡くなりました。
Many people died due to the coronavirus. So the second method is by or through a method or a way to do something.
インターネットによってたくさんの情報を知りました。
I knew many information through internet.
によって is also used for a passive sentence.
This means by.
インスタントラーメンは日本人によって発明されました。
Instant noodle was invented by a Japanese. So by is
によって。
And then the last usage is depends on. So this is what we have done just now.
国によって違います。
It depends on the country. So in this sentence, we cannot use よって。The answer is
渡って。11番。先生に何々そのような言い方をするのは失礼ですよ。先生に何々そのような言い方をするのは失礼ですよ。A.対して B. とって
Now what is the answer?
The answer is A. 対して So 対して has a meaning of in contrast to
However, it also has a meaning of towards, against So, 先生に対して means toward a teacher. そのような is that kind of. 言い方 is a way to say something. So, this sentence means it is impolite to talk like that to your teacher. The answer is に対して。にとって means from the standpoint of. So, in this case, we cannot use it in this sentence.
12番。年を取るに、何々、目が悪くなりました。年を取るに、何々、目が悪くなりました。A is, 連れて。B is, 比べて。
Now, what is the answer?
The answer is, 連れて。
So, verb, dictionary form plus に連れて。Noun plus に連れて。This means, as in proportion to. So it describes the changes, effect, influence that accompanies a prior change.
So, 年を取るにつれて.
This means, as I get old.
目が悪くなりました.
My eyesight became bad. So the answer is,
つれて. 比べて means,
comparing.
So, 夏に比べて冬は寒いです。夏に比べて冬は寒いです。
Comparing to summer, winter is cold.
13番。私の好きなサッカーチームは最近負け何々です。私の好きなサッカーチームは最近負け何々です。
A is たまま。B is, 話し。Now what is the answer? The answer is,
話し。私の好きなサッカーチーム。
My favorite soccer team. 最近 is, recently.
負けます is to lose.
So, 他 form plus, まま。Stem word plus, 話し。So both means,to leave something at a certain state. So for example,
1時間経ったままだ.
This means, I had been standing for an hour. We can also use,
1時間立ちっぱなしだ.
These are the same meaning. 他 form plus まま or stem word plus ぱなし can be used when the resulting action remains unchanged. So this means that,It is used for verbs which describe change that is more or less instantaneous. So for example,
開けます to open.
I can do it in 1 second.
立ちます to stand up.
I can do it in 1 second. However, 他 form plus まま cannot be used for verbs which describe activities that last for some time. So for example,
歌います to sing,
I cannot do in 1 second.
読みます to read,
I cannot do in 1 second. So this is the same.
負けます to lose,
I also cannot do in 1 second. Therefore, in this sentence, we cannot use たまま. The only possibility here is ぱなし. So,
負けっぱなしです。私の好きなサッカーチームは最近負けっぱなしです。
This means, my favorite soccer team is keep on losing these days. So the answer is B,
悲しい。14番。会社の発表に、何々、もうすぐ新しい製品が出るそうです。会社の発表に、何々、もうすぐ新しい製品が出るそうです。
A is, 寄れば。B is, 寄って。Now what is the answer? The answer is,
に寄れば。
So, something に寄れば means according to. 会社 company 発表 announcement. So, according to the announcement of the company,もうすぐ is soon.
新しい製品
new product. 出ます。is to be released. Plain form plus そうです means I heard that. Hearsay. So this sentence means according to the announcement of the company, there will be some new products soon. We also have another expression for according to, which is によると. So these are the same meaning. によると、によれば are according to.よって Now we have already studied this. There are four meanings. One is due to, because of. The second one is through a method. Third one is by someone. This is used for passive sentence. And the fourth one is depends on. In this case, we cannot use. So the answer is によれば。
15番この料理は作り何々だからまだ食べないでください。この料理は作り何々だからまだ食べないでください。
A is かけ B is ガチ Now what is the answer? The answer is かけ Stem word plus かける Stem word plusかけの plus noun, it expresses an action that was being carried out before it was stopped prior to completion. So in this case,
この料理は
this food
作りかけ
So we haven't finished it yet. It's prior to the completion. So it's still making. So that's why
まだ食べないでください。
So, please don't eat yet. So, stem word plus かけ is the answer. Stem word plus ガチ is used for tendency. So, it describes that a thing or a person is tend to be like that or might become like that. So, for example,
電車は遅れがちです。電車は遅れがちです。
The train tends to be late. So, in this case, the answer is
作りかけ
Haven't finished making food. So this is all for today. Please write down your score in the comment box below. Please also let me know if you have any questions or comments.
ありがとうございました。バイバイ。